saying that government has cut the October to December local gas prices to $3.82 per MMBTU from $4.66 per MMBTU. So now it's fallen below $4 per MMBTU. This was expected. This is effective the 1st of October, and this could be on account of subdued demand as well as the lower crude prices. It will be negative for companies like ONGC. So ONGC stock should come up on your screen because this gas represents close to about 40% of ONGC's production and 23% of the turnover, but the stock is actually reacting upwards. But our analysis had showed up that ONGC perhaps would be negatively impacted. But a lower gas price would be positive for power producers as well as fertilizer stocks, because that goes in as an input to fertilizer as well as power. In fact, let's go across to Nayantara Rai. She joins us for more on this. Nayantara, what are you picking up?
So, you know, tomorrow is 1st October, so there has to be a new gas price. It has to be made effective. And like we've been reporting on CNBC TV 18, because of the gas price formula, the way it is structured, the kind of weightage it provides to the Henry Hub gas price, the kind of weightage it provides to crude prices, etc., we are expecting a sharp fall to come in as far as the new gas price of India goes. It is being seen maybe a cut 15% to 20%, which would mean around $4 per MMBTU. The press release has to still be uploaded officially, but this is the plan. India does revise its gas prices every 6 months. The new one has to be made effective tomorrow, and it's always done with a lag. This is for the regular gas price. Don't forget also that India has to notify a price for the deep water gas, which is far more expensive to explore. So it's going to be interesting to see that once the press release is uploaded on the website with the official new price effective 1st October, if it's also going to have a second gas price, which could be for deep water, ultra deep water exploration. This is of course going to have huge ramifications, whether it's for the power sector, the fertilizer sector, since it's a raw material for all of those businesses.
All right, Nayantara, thanks so much for joining in with all those details. We have Varinadar with us as well in the studio. Varinadar, I'm just reading a report out. It's supposed to hurt ONGC. It's supposed to be a positive for GAIL, I believe. And in fact, minimal impact on Reliance Industries. Just take us through a stock impact.
Well, you know, this is based on a formula, and the revision, as Nayantara rightly pointed out, it happens after 6 months. So this comes as no surprise for some of the analysts on the street. But if I have to focus on the companies, clearly, you know, this may be a bad news for ONGC. The reason is clearly because the gas represents nearly 40% of ONGC's production and nearly 23% of its turnover. You know, but the stock has almost, you know, what, fallen to 225. So, you know, whether it's almost in the price or not, that we have to see. But, you know, on report from Edelweiss coming in the morning clearly said that if this happens, you know, the ONGC's FY16 EPS may get impacted by nearly 5%. So watch out for that. The biggest beneficiary of this will be city gas distribution companies, clearly. You know, lower gas prices will benefit, you know, companies like IGL, Gujarat Gas. Just, you know, if we can get IGL stock on the screen, Indraprastha Gas Limited, that is company because it has nearly 83% of volumes coming from CNG and PNG business. Look at IGL, you know, that stock is spiking up. IGL is one. Also watch out for Gujarat Gas. Gujarat Gas is now listed, but now it is being traded in a trade-to-trade segment. It comes out of T2T segment tomorrow. That is Gujarat Gas. That is another company which will benefit out of this because clearly the volumes will be driven by competitiveness. Now, CNG versus petrol and diesel, and CNG now being one of the cheapest for most of the users, that is one company to focus on. GAIL will be marginally benefited because the input cost of LPG is one. So watch out for that, but clearly thumbs up to IGL.
Okay, so negative news for ONGC, positive for IGL and Gujarat Gas. But let's get in an expert. Mr. R.S. Sharma joins in now. Good morning, sir. Thanks for joining in. Sources are suggesting that gas prices could be cut by 18% effective 1st of October. So from $4.66 per MMBTU, it could come down below $4 or $3.82 per MMBTU. Your initial reaction, and is it in line with what the expectation was?
Yeah, it is in line with the expectations, the pricing, but I have been always critical of this new formulation which they have made it, and all the benchmarks they are using is for exporting countries or producing countries, not the importing countries. India happily imports this LNG at prices higher than $8, $10, $12, and we don't want to pay the domestic producers any representative price. That is very unfortunate. I would put it that for the new exploration and production in the country, it's a very, very negative news.
So what is the solution, sir, in that case? Because
solution, they have to revise the formulation. Nothing short of that. If they want to promote the E&P industry in India, they have to give a more reasonable price to the producers. They can't, if they have to protect the consumers, let them do the way they are doing for the crude oil and the petroleum products. They can subsidize, the buyers. But so far as the producer is concerned, he is legitimately entitled for a market-determined price. And this is not market-determined price.
But that is clearly reflected in the way ONGC stock has been behaving, sir. I remember way you when you left,
ONGC,
you know.
ONGC, all the existing players and all the future exploration. Now, launching that, new marginal fields and the next melt round to be launched. Who will come and invest at these prices in this country?
But isn't it in parallel with what is happening in the global commodity markets, because the natural gas prices are falling down. So it's just in parallel with what it is happening and based on the formula.
No, they are falling down in the countries which are surplus in gas. Look at the countries which are importing. Why don't we compare ourselves with China, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, who are the net importers?
Yes, this is the criticism about the formula that it's based on gas export hubs of Russia, Alberta, Henry Hub, etc. But Mr. Sharma,
Henry Hub, they are not, represented prices for India.
Okay, Mr. Sharma, if you could just stay on. We're also joined by Mr. Jal Irani of Edelweiss Financial Services. Hi, Jal. Good morning. Your initial reactions and the stock impact. We've already seen IGL Gujarat Gas perk up, while ONGC is a bit subdued. Is there more of a reaction to play out?
Yeah, hi, and hello, Mr. Sharma, as well. The impact, I think, is fairly straightforward. Needless to say, ONGC is the largest... it's simple. Essentially, the producers of gas with the 18% cut would obviously get hurt. And the consumers of gas, primarily the city gas companies, will benefit. So how does the producers get hurt and who are the big producers? Essentially, ONGC is obviously the largest with about 40% of production, upstream production coming from gas, about 23% of turnover. So essentially, we estimate that it would be a impact of 5% on earnings because of this cut in the second half. And in the case of city gas, Indraprastha gas, roughly about 80% of its gas is based on gas sourcing is this domestic gas. So Indraprastha's gas's profit should increase by 5%. If it doesn't pass on the benefit to the consumer. But my thought is that it will pass on the benefit to the consumer to enhance volumes instead, because gas competes with diesel, and as the diesel prices have come down, what they'd like to do is essentially increase volumes rather than simply just margin straight away.
Jal, this is Varinder. Okay, I don't know whether you've studied Gujarat gas or not. So have you any implications on what happens to Gujarat gas apart from IGL?
So while we don't have Gujarat gas under formal coverage, we do have a look at it. And Gujarat gas will also be a beneficiary. But unlike Indraprastha gas, where 80% of its turnover comes from city gas, which is really the input for the which is domestically produced gas, in the case of Gujarat gas, it's the other way around. Mm-hmm. Only 20-25% or a much smaller component is the city gas business, which is supplied by the domestic gas price, which has been cut. So it would be a much smaller beneficiary.
What happens to GAIL?
GAIL would, again, benefit, but then marginally again, because our understanding is that in the case of the LPG business, the import cost is still pegged to domestic gas. So to that extent, their cost should reduce. But then in the context of the size of the company, I mean, the other significant businesses that they do, essentially petrochemicals being a very large one, where they've just doubled the capacity. And, of course, pipeline and international gas imports, etc., this is again a relatively smaller component. So GAIL would also benefit, but again in a smaller way.
You know, okay. Jal, I was reading your note where you mentioned that domestic gas prices could be cut to $4.2 per MMBTU. What we are getting in news is that it could be cut to nearly 3.82.
No. So there is a gross calorific value, and then there's a net calorific value. This 4.24 is exactly what was as per expectations. So the 4.24 is on net calorific value, which compares to 4.2, which was expected in the press earlier itself.
Okay. Jal, if you're not mistaken, we thought the gas production had is already at a four-year low, at least as of last year. With lower gas prices, is it going to hurt even more? And what would your estimates be of gas production going forward, and how will it impact?
So needless to say, it disincentivizes domestic gas production, as Mr. Sharma very correctly pointed out 5 minutes back. I mean, at $4.2, really your economics of producing gas domestically is marginal at best, especially because incrementally a bulk of your domestic resources are in deep waters and tougher terrains. So even if you look at the Deen Dayal block for GSPC, the parent of GSPL, While that is shallow waters, it's also very high pressure, very hot gas. So that also makes it rather expensive. Similarly, if you look at ONGC's upcoming deep water KG, the company would be in a better position to say where the viability sits, but it's probably more in the region of $6 to $8 in MMBTU, despite actually deep water rig rates halving to about $300,000 a day. Despite that, it's a very expensive gas. I understand, in fact, from what ONGC has been saying in the past, even Mumbai High, which is one of the most prolific fields in the world, and in fact half of the country's production, I understand even from Mumbai High, the break-even is not much lower than 4.2. I think it's 3.8 or even upwards of that. So, frankly, domestic production incrementally, other than what has been committed by the 12-odd ONGC's marginal fields going into production, incrementally it's difficult to for anybody to commit any serious capital to upstream exploration in the country.
Okay. All right, Jal, thanks so much for joining and giving us all those details. But let's